If anything's to be remembered about 2023, it's the year we rebelled against a movement from the depths of hell.
The hundreds, if not thousands, swarming around Dodger Stadium for Pride Night 2023. Throngs of the faithful, a coalition of Catholic and Christian groups and activists, protesting what they consider an affront to their religion.
And drag are heavily made up with different names and personas.
They feel that they need to do this.
So, as activists, we cannot fault anyone for using protests, but peaceful.
We will honor our king.
Everybody, there's kids here! Stop!
For much of the day, a row of police officers stood outside Satakoy Elementary and tried to keep the two sides apart. Even when they blocked each other's paths and got in each other's faces.
Do you think this is the appropriate way to dress?
I'm covered. You are dressed like a whore in front of children. Are you teaching children to be whores?
You're dressed like this.
You're not a woman, so you're a man, sir. Sir, you're a man.
Tell them how we feel about it.
But counter-protesters argue signs reading stop grooming or sexualizing our kids tell a different story.
Our protest is against LAUSD.
Protesters tell us they kept their kids home today, but others sent their children to school.
Oh, boy. Wow.
Look at this image. This was in the book, and they all unanimously said that this, and along with that 15-page... Okay, this is in children's libraries here in Hillsborough County, approved by that committee unanimously at Plant High. It's in multiple schools. There's 10 images of that woman's naked breasts in that book.
Hey, everyone. This is Jedi Battlemaster Kos. I know you haven't heard from me in a bit. I am the Jedi Exile, and we are unfortunately in the midst of the most demonic month of the year. It is upon us, and we all know what I'm talking about. This disgusting modern tradition of Pride Month. I originally had this video planned for New Year's, or perhaps even Valentine's Day. However, I thought it was fitting with my suspension from Twitter, as well as my most recent move into this new place, to release it now. And it doesn't seem like, it didn't seem like I would to fulfill that scheduled drop. So as you know, moving is kind of a taxing and lengthy process. The unpacking, getting settled even more so. And now seems like as apt a time as any. But people are really out here celebrating this demonic sex cult. And it's really sad, to be honest. I mean, I've seen how many lives this sick ideology has taken, brainwashed, and destroyed. Some of whom I know personally, or knew personally. And I have to say that every victory against this nonsense and this pervasive evil will be something I gladly celebrate. So, this past year, 2023, Christians in California took a stand against the evil sex cult we all know as the LGBT movement. Or should we even call it LGBT now? I mean, it's been LGBT for the past 20-something years, but now, all of a sudden, the moment has come where they want a divorce from the T. Oh, yeah. So I always suspected that the trans portion of the movement would spell death for the entire LGBT community, if you want to call it that. And this past year, the backlash against the entire cult has destroyed its PR that it's gained over the past 15-20 years, and the whole the whole movement is a lot more pungent. The stink has not left it. The past year has shown us just how much the trans community has destroyed all the PR that the entire LGBT cult has built up over the past 20-something years, with homosexuals suddenly wanting to distance themselves from the mentally ill and pedophilic labels that have been attached to the whole Troon community. So it's become so bad that they even had a whole Gays Against Groomers Twitter page, founded so that they can maintain some kind of public image. You know, totally disregarding the rampant pedophilic behavior that's being normalized at events such as gay pride parades, with some parents, quote-unquote, parents, willingly take their children to, so they can witness rampant sexual degeneracy firsthand, you know, just like any normal parent. I mean, you think they just admit that everything churches have been saying about the LGBT movement back in the early 2000s were factual, and that homosexuality and its promotion is just a massive Trojan horse for pedophilia.
Now, when I was growing up here, sex was only between the male and female. Now it's between Adam and Adam, Eve and Eve, which I can't understand. They talk about discrimination and people's rights, okay? The thing about it is you have rights and you have human rights, but you have inhuman rights. If a man deal with another man, a woman deal with another man, that's considered as inhuman. So me as a man that deal with the opposite sex, I don't say you could put the two together. You have to separate them. Once you separate them, that would be discrimination, because discrimination is a negative and a positive. Me as a black man, when they discriminated against me, I came out of my mother's womb black. I didn't have a choice. That was a negative discrimination. If you discriminate against a homosexual, that's a positive. Why? Because of children. You got people they call pedophiles. Then you got pedophilia. What is pedophilia? It's when your deception is Adam and Adam, Eve and Eve, and you're going to look in the eyes of a child, and you're going to tell a child it's sexy between Adam, Adam, Eve and Eve. You become a pedophile. These books here, when they talk about king and king, And this Prince, Marry Another Prince, is a pedophile book. This book here that says Heaven, Heather is a pedophile book. Pedophilia. This book here to talk about Daddy's Roommate is a pedophile book. This book here to talk about all families are different has to do with what? You have, God's family, which is a natural family, and you have the Antichrist family. Either you Christ or you Antichrist. Make your decision what you're going to be. You cannot be both. But if you can look in the eyes of a child and tell a child they have a choice to be heterosexual, homosexual, you have a serious problem.
I mean, the end goal of the entire LGBT movement was always to add that P at the end. We know that. Because in a movement about sexuality that is just solely focused on who you're screwing, if a man can screw a man and have it be called normal, he can screw anything and have it be called normal. Yeah. The past year has proven to me that the church, and at least some of the church, some of its members have finally grown a pair and have decided to stick up for what's right again. And suffice to say, I'm very proud of the voices who have stood up against this nonsense happening and have stood up for the church in the face of its mockery by these degenerates who spit in the face of God, who try to do their best to mock Christianity when they know that in the end, God doesn't love them for what they've done. They know that in the end, their sin is not going to fly with the Almighty. And they have to turn away from their sin, but they don't want to do that. They've been told this a million times, and they still don't listen. They're defiant like children. And you just, honestly, God, like, you have to stand up to them or else it's never going to change. There are way more of us than there are of them. And so I don't know why the past 15 years... the church has been so slow to action until this point. And that's because, actually, you know what? I do know, because the church has been infiltrated quite successfully. And ever since the early 2000s, it's been nonstop infiltration of the church by these people. I don't even know if I can call them people. These demons wearing skin suits. But as far as last year and its events, I wanted to highlight the complete and utter backlash the LGBT movement has been facing, actually over the past three or four years, actually. And I think in America especially, and this isn't even counting abroad, where they've taken major L's, like in Japan and Ghana, and basically other countries in Africa, standing against homosexuality. All of the West African, African Methodist churches, I know they had some big council or meeting back in the past regarding gay marriage in the church, which is tells you all you need to know. It's not about acceptance. It's about forcing you to accept something that's contrary to your religion and contrary to what you believe, to force you to change your beliefs. They had some kind of vote, and all the African churches were like, basically like, no, no, we don't, like, this is against the Bible, which it literally is. And I'm telling you, all of the churches that have LGBT preachers, they should be shut down. I can only imagine how low their attendance is. The people that put them in there should at least be excommunicated from any kind of church. They should not have any kind of dealings going into any church. And people wonder why a church, or at least the mega churches, have been in decline, or the big churches have been in decline. And it's because of this. People see, oh my God, these agents see, oh my God, it's a church. I guess I better infiltrate and get close to the pastor. That's basically literally what happened at the last church I was at in Rhode Island. But when we say that, oh, the churches have warned us against this, the slippery slope was real, they want to mock us. They've always mocked us. And you know what? I've seen a lot of people, a lot of so-called Christians, fall for the propaganda and be like, oh, well, we just have to conform and everything will just be okay. Everything will be all good, guys, if we just conform to the ways of the world, which are exactly the things that Jesus tells us not to do. They want to be socially accepted by everyone, but they don't want to follow the word of God. And I have to say, I must thank the LGBT movement for one thing. At least it's exposed all of the fake Christians out there. All the fake Christians who claim to follow Christ, claim to be biblical and to love God, but meanwhile, they're accepting homosexuality as legitimate. they're accepting this cult of Satan that has been propped up by our leftist government, that has been propped up by all these leftist organizations. They're supporting that. This tool that they basically want to use for population control, because when a guy and a girl aren't screwing, then there's no chance of a child. So they want to promote that as much as possible. Get the kids in it too. That's what they're doing now. They want that for the next generation, so they don't have to deal with a population explosion that they cannot control, because it's always about control. They want to control the populace, but they don't want to have death camps and all the nasty imagery that goes along with that, because they don't want to be seen as hypocrites. or similar to the Nazis, which they definitely are. They just go about it through different means. So yeah, the sex cult that is the LGBT movement was blasted at the LA Dodgers protest last year. They were blasted by students, parents, even some teachers were attending these school board meetings where they were basically reading aloud what they are teaching kids. And some of the school boards were like, oh, no, you need to stop reading that. Why? That's what you're teaching our kids. It was so graphic. They had to ask some of these parents to stop reading aloud the trash, that the LGBT trash that they are infecting your children's minds with. The sexually degenerate trash that they are infecting your kids' minds with.
This is shameful, base, and degrading. All seven members of the committee were also asked to look at this image. This was in the book, and they all unanimously said that this, and along with that 15-page... Okay, this is in children's libraries here in Hillsborough County, approved by that committee unanimously at Plant High. It's in multiple schools. There's
another thing that's very telling on the subject of these homoerotic books was when Governor DeSantis of Florida signed a bill basically stating that these books are no longer allowed in the state of Florida's schools, middle elementary schools, and the LGBT community was freaking out. Even more recently, when they were basically like, "Yeah, you cannot push this ideology to minors. You cannot push LGBT crap on minors. You cannot push." Minors cannot have transgender surgeries or whatnot. Oh, they were freaking out. They were freaking out, bro. Like, all over Twitter, they were like, oh my god, DeSantis is killing us. Don't go to Florida, guys. Don't go to Florida. No, you can't just sign laws that protect the parents' right to keep their children from being taught our sexuality. You can't just do that, guys. Oh my god, yo. I mean, you know, DeSantis is he was growing on me for a bit there, you know. He's all right, don't get me wrong, but I just think he's over eager for the presidency. But yeah, like there were a ton of other flashpoints this past year that just really, really were bad looks for the entire LGBT community, I mean, and their agenda of promoting pedophilia, because that's ultimately what they do. You know, that's the ultimate goal. The ultimate goal in everything they do is to promote pedophiles. Yeah. I mean, imagine pushing this stuff to kids. I mean, it's disgusting. There's no other word for it. I mean, you know, these are kids. These are kids. And they'll be damaged for life. Damaged. You know, they'll either, at the least, they'll probably become addicted to porn or whatever. At the worst, they're probably going to become a transgender whatever abomination and start taking hormones to sterilize themselves and cut off parts of their own body, you know, because this movement has convinced kids that they aren't okay the way they are, but yet and still they somehow are okay the way they are, and that's okay. You see how that doesn't make sense? You see how that doesn't make sense? Yeah. So this is the insanity that the LA Dodgers protest was facing. They were facing off against these degenerate nuns, or people that dress up as nuns, they're homosexuals, who go around twerking on crosses and all that, mocking God, mocking Jesus, mocking everybody that ever died who was a Christian, every nun who ever felt the need to be chaste or anything like that, or, you know, they're mocking every virtue, basically, and making fools of themselves. And people had it. People were done. You know, they were so done. And the good thing is, they don't expect you. They feel like we're losing steam. We're still here. We're still Christians. There's still billions of us.
They came by the hundreds, if not thousands, swarming around Dodger Stadium for Pride Night 2023. Throngs of the Faithful, a coalition of Catholic and Christian groups and activists, protesting what they consider an affront to their religion and core belief.
Jesus Christ is not only our Lord, he's the Lord of America.
Before the Dodgers took on the San Francisco Giants, they paid special tribute to a group called the Sisters of Perpetual Indulgence. The members in drag are heavily made up with different names and personas, but all don variations of the traditional nun's habit. That fact distresses or outrages countless Catholics and Christians, driving many of them to demonstrate and rally before Friday night's game, the culmination of weeks of fiery debate and flip-flopping. First, the Dodgers invited the sisters to Pride Night, then disinvited them, then re-invited them. Finally, on the field, when the stadium was still fairly empty before the festivities, the ball club honored the group with the 2023 Community Hero Award for charitable and humanitarian work.
That filled me not only with joy and gladness, but a sense of safeness and security, and a sense that who I am, as ridiculous as this may be, is welcome on the face of the earth.
I think everyone's after a good cause.
Even though that happened, people could kind of learn a lesson from it and still be able to love and, like, invite people and just be open with everybody.
Not everyone is supportive.
Yeah, my concerns is that they're not sisters, and they're ridiculing the good sisters in the Catholic Church.
We're here to pray for them as well, because we don't know why they feel that they need to do this.
I mean, there were thousands of people over there just shutting it down, and I applaud every single one of them. They went to do what a lot of people couldn't do or wouldn't do, you know. And for a brief moment, the control of the people who have infiltrated Christianity was broken, and we need to build on this momentum. If you want to fight back against these sexual weirdos who have poisoned our society, now is the time. Now is the time to build on this momentum and to keep going forward bravely. The fight is long and it's hard, but we don't give up. And you should be filled with the Spirit of the Almighty whenever you go to war against these people. And war doesn't have to be with guns. It does not have to be with weapons or anything like that. The truth is a weapon enough. And we need to be more active. We need more of this, you know, more organization, more protesting. But, you know, as long as we have these weaklings as our pastors who have been co-opted by this movement to make us weak and to not focus on what really matters anymore, because we feel, or at least they feel, the battle is lost. You know, the battle is the battle really lost? If the battle is lost, then the future of humanity is lost. And the future of what you believe in is lost, or what you claim to believe in is lost.
Prepare for battle.
Then you're all talk, and talk is cheap. if you don't actually get out there, organize, do something, I mean, at least like show that you're not with it, you know, at least show that you're not with the cult, you know, at least show where your loyalties lie, you know. And they can't, a lot of these modern pastors can't even do that. They keep focusing on what Orange Man Drumpf said in 2017 on Twitter. You know, their focus is completely off, and thus the entire congregation's focus is completely off. What's important, and that is the attack on marriage and the family. You know, people talking about, marriage, love is love. No, it is not. Because you know exactly what a phrase like love is love leads to. Madness. And to continue off of that topic, I'm not sure how many of you remember the hashtag leave the kids alone or leave our kids alone following Call of Duty getting absolutely destroyed. Call of Duty, the game, which has not been good for the past 8, almost 10 years now. Call of Duty basically getting triggered over one of their top players saying, leave the kids alone on Twitter. Like, can you imagine that? Like, what a milquetoast statement for them to get triggered over. I wonder what that has to do with LGBT. I wonder why leaving the kids alone is a bad thing for LGBT. I wonder why that's targeting LGBT people, quote unquote. Gee, guys, I wonder. But yeah, that also blew up. And this isn't even to mention Bud Light losing like more money than we could ever dream of. This isn't even to mention that. But it's just, there were so many things, negative PR bombs that were hitting the LGBT movement all last year. And are continuing to hit it this year, because this year you hardly ever see, you see a lot less of it now. It's been sort of dampened, the spirit of the LGBT pride, I guess. It wasn't as prevalent everywhere. People weren't as festive, I noticed that. But it's just funny to me that this had to happen for people to see the intent of this movement, that it had to get this far before they could finally be like, wow, well, maybe the Christians were right all along. And it was just hilarious seeing Dylan Mulvaney get absolutely destroyed by and basically tank the whole brand of Bud Light for a good long time. That was nice. That was very nice. Loved it. Bud Light got absolutely destroyed. Target lost billions. I don't even know how. Hold up. How many billions did Bud Light lose? Dang, over a billion. Over a billion in lost sales. Jesus. Almost a billion and a half. $1.5 billion in revenue over the boycott. Jeez, man. Oof. So, you see, guys, when we organize, we win. And these people that want to hold you back, all these people that are saying, oh, no, don't do that, guys. We don't focus on that here, guys. They are trying to subvert you. Don't listen to them. You know, I mean, because that's why they want to infiltrate the church. They want to subvert you from within. And if you don't have the will to fight and combat these people spiritually, you will lose. Expose these false prophets wherever they are. Organize and win. The Bud Light boycott, a W. The Target boycott, a W. I mean, people were oh yeah, the Disney boycott, a kind of a W, because Disney is still in its, I guess, in its death throes right now. They're just going all out with DEI, but they messed with Florida, and Florida is getting ready to kick them out. So I don't know if that's a W or not. It's still ongoing. We're still dealing with the fallout from that one. But it's just amusing to me. But props to all the people that, all the parents that showed how much they cared about their kids by showing up and fighting for them in the streets, whether or not it's against the gay pride movement in our schools, them trying to indoctrinate our kids, get them hooked into this lifestyle early so that they can sterilize them later on, get them all brainwashed into accepting this garbage. Brainwash them into accepting all this. And just props to those parents that showed up in LA, all over the country, Michigan, all over the country, to protest against the degenerate nonsense that is being shoved in our kids' heads. Well, you know, the next generation's heads. You know, and to fight for
it. No.
Oh boy. Wow. Okay.
Tensions boil over and come to blows. One person is injured, despite pleas for calm.
Everybody, there's kids here, stop!
For much of the day, a row of police officers stood outside Satakoi Elementary and tried to keep the two sides apart. Even when they blocked each other's paths and got in each other's faces. The school became the center of protest after some parents learned that a video of a book where it says some kids have two mommies, some have two daddies, would be played at a Pride assembly. This mother, who helped organize the protest, says she should have been given the choice of opting her child out of attending.
This is not the right message for kids, to confuse them at this age, what's, you know, what kind of families are out there, because they don't know anything. They are, I mean, they don't understand.
Use the momentum that we gained this year from all the protests. You know, there's a video out there where a guy, a Christian, several Christians break up a drag queen story hour because, you know, their drag queen story. It's a drag queen story hour. They, I don't know if you guys have seen that meme yet of the goose chasing behind the guy saying, "Hey, why don't you read to anyone else besides children? Like, why don't you guys go to the nursing homes and read to the elderly people? Like, why is it always children?" And he's chasing behind the guy demanding answers. Like, why is it always the children? You know, because their end goal is pedophilia. They want to add that P on there. And I told you guys this before, you know. And it seems like everybody is realizing that now. Everyone is just realizing what Christians have been on about for the past 20 years. Like, we don't even really have to say anything. People are just now realizing that the Christians were trying to warn you this entire time of what was going to come with this twisted ideology. We were warning you the whole time, you know, and now you're starting to see what's happening. Churches that promote LGBT ideology are dwindling. Their numbers are evaporating. And now you're starting to see what's happening. Churches that promote LGBT ideology are dwindling. Their numbers are evaporating. And to be honest, we've been looking for a solution. And people like, there's a YouTube channel out there, that is proposing solutions for Christians that have left an extremely liberal church, basically a heretic church, that have left a heretic church and are seeking new churches. There are people out there that are urging them to, you know, just take, instead of running, take back your church. Yeah, you could form another church, but take back the old church, you know, take back these historic churches, you know, take it back, you know, do what they did, you know, just introduce new people, you know, introduce a bunch of conservatives in there, because if the liberals aren't dedicated to the cause, they're not going to stick around. You know, they just want to act like the victims. But once the conservatives outnumber the liberals, you take it over. And this YouTuber, his name is Redeem Zoomer. Check out his channel. He has a lot of views, a lot of subscribers, but check out his channel. He's a Christian YouTuber just like me, and he speaks on matters of faith all the time, and he has some really entertaining videos. But this has been the year that everyone, that the mask has come completely off of the LGBT agenda, and that agenda being pedophilia. In fact, it's gotten so bad that there's been an alleged divorce within the movement, the divorce of the T from reality. And the divorce of the LGB from the T, which is really ironic, because the whole thing started as LGBT. The whole thing started 20 years plus ago as LGBT. And it's always been LGBT to our knowledge. And now all of a sudden it's like, oh, well, we have to do damage control. Now all of a sudden the movement is in damage control. We have gays against groomers on Twitter. We have Facebook pages saying that they want a divorce from the T and like criticizing the T, but like still promoting the degenerate nonsense that comes with the LGB. Yeah. And I think they're all starting to slowly realize, like, hey, like the whole thing is corrupt. The whole thing is degenerate. The whole thing is disgusting and vile. And I think the bad PR is just hilarious to me. The fact that they had to form an organization to combat their own movement's bad PR moves, was hilarious to me. The gays against groomers talking about, oh, how, yeah, we don't support that. But meanwhile, you know, studies show that people who are sexually degenerate, like, you know, people of this community, there's a high likelihood that they were sexually abused. And it's just fascinating that movement is just starting to call out his own people. It's just like, oh, wow, well, we've delved into it's a too far territory now. I mean, they kind of sound like us like 15 years ago. Oh, man, like, yeah, we don't want to be doing that because it makes, you know. But they do it because they don't want to look bad. They don't want their movement to look bad. Oh, man, all the progress we've made for LGBTQ rights. Like, what progress? What rights have you guys obtained, you know? Like, what have you guys done except pressure Christians to go against their own values? What have you done? I mean, really? And it's been a string of legal victories as well. Like, you know, you no longer have to bake the cake at gunpoint if you don't want to. But it's... the protests in the schools and whatnot, they need to evolve into mass protests against this ideology. This ideology that teaches kids to hate themselves, that teaches, that takes broken people and tells them, okay, yeah, it's, you know, it's okay to make a family without a mother or without a father. You know, yeah, like, it's totally legit, bro. Like, it's totally legit that this family doesn't have a father. You know, it's totally legit that this family doesn't have a mother. You know, it's totally legit that that you can change your gender or your ID, that your you know, that you can change your sex or whatever, take surgery to change your sex. We have to destroy this ideology at its source, and that source is self-hatred and even hatred of others. Like, lesbianism, I'm pretty sure, comes from a hatred of men and a need to understand them. And the same with gayness and sodomy and all that, comes from a hatred of women and trying to, you know, that's why you have so many guys out there trying to act like women, you know, so many gays out there trying to act like women. And it's really repulsive. It's disgusting. The things that they do around kids, they outright said it last year, like, hey, we're going to indoctrinate your children into our cult. It really is a cult. And it's sad that I've seen so many of my friends fall into this cult ideology and its messaging. It's a freaking cult, you know, and it's a pedophile cult. The only thing, they're trying to wait until that perfect time before they come and outright just say, admit, okay, yeah, we're adding the P on, we're adding the pedophile on. And, you know, we're starting to see the fracture. You know, that's where a lot of principled gay people seem to have a problem with, is the inevitability of the P being added onto it, just like we always said it would be. Just like we always said it would be. And now they're realizing that everything the Christians said was right. The Christians were trying to warn y'all, and y'all didn't listen. And now we just have to sit back and watch their whole movement burn. You know, we really don't have to protest, but just to make a point, you know, we probably should. You know, we probably should, because we are what we tolerate, aren't we? We are what we tolerate. And so, you know, a lot of these books are being banned from schools now. 2023 saw a lot of the banning of these sexually degenerate books from schools, depicting gay sex acts and trying to indoctrinate children early. We have people that have stories from their horrific experiences with the transgender movement. We have ex-gays. We have people who have left the LGBT cult that realize that it's nothing but it's not natural. It's not going to lead to a healthy life, you know, and they've left that, praise God. And I, you know, every time someone leaves this cult, this LGBT ideology, I praise God for saving another soul, because I pray for that all the time. There are several people back home that I know that, you know, I check up on them, and what do you know, they're in the cults. And I pray for them, you know, I pray for them every day, because this cult will, it's like a mind warping, you know, kind of virus, this ideology. And, you know, there's so much wrong with it. You know, all the STDs, all the freaking degenerate shit that they put out, like, it's just, it's just all the nonsense that you see them do. It's just like, what else are these people going to do? Yeah, and the more recent example being of the ideology being pushed in mass media, Doctor Who, a character beloved by many, and Superman, another character beloved by many. Superman's son is apparently gay now, and they're trying to make a gay Superman, trying to make a gay Doctor Who to push the gay agenda. You know, it's just, it's everywhere, and it's such obvious propaganda. And it's little wonder why comic sales are dipping, why these people are so upset and protesting everything being shown in these books, protesting the gay lifestyle. And a lot of these liberals, these blue pink-haired weirdos that support the Muslim community, are shocked absolutely shocked and flabbergasted that the Muslim community does not support homosexuality. They do not support that shit. You know, even though they, you know, can try and taqiyya you into believing elsewise, well, you know, but they do not. They are less tolerant of it than we are. You know, and it used to be the other way around, you know, but now it's like to see Christians and Muslims uniting against the threat of the LGBT cult, the sexually degenerate cult. And, you know, we try to warn y'all that these are, they're trying to normalize this nonsense so that, you know, sexually immoral acts can be normal. So that they can, oh, well, you know, you can't prosecute me for that. Well, it's normal now. It's socially acceptable, bro. You should just sit back and just accept it. You know, it's not anything, there's not anything wrong with it. You know, that's what they're trying to do. And to see them do that, to see them pushing this, really kind of confirms everything that we've been saying, and confirms that Pizzagate is most likely real. That there are, we weren't supposed to find out about Epstein. We weren't supposed to find out about all these elite pedophiles. We weren't supposed to find out about Prince Andrew and how he was connected to Epstein and all these different pedophile rings that they say it's all conspiracy theory, but then we keep finding these pedophile rings, and it really makes you wonder, like, dang, like, you know, politicians getting caught with this mayor, this first openly gay mayor, in fact, just got caught with a ton of child porn. And I mean, it just seems like the connection between, you know, the LGBT community and child porn and child abuse is just so, you know, strong. I mean, I don't know, like, maybe there's something there. I mean, like, maybe there's some connection there. But yeah, I know any community can have its pedophiles, but it's especially strong within the LGBT community. You know, and I'm just like, if you haven't seen the connections yet, if you haven't seen the writing on the wall yet, like, what's wrong with you? You know, it's just, it's satanic. It's just satanic child abuse cult. That's what it is. It's a satanic child abuse cult. It's a satanic grooming cult. That's what the LGBT ideology is. Yeah. And they march in the streets with signs saying that they love Satan, you know. And this movement has been taking L after L this year. And in 2024, I can only hope for more. I mean, even in other countries, they've been taking L's. In Japan, they upheld their values that, hey, we don't support this gay shit. You know, we don't support it. You know, and of course, probably Soros had one of his agents kill Shinzo Abe, assassinate him. You know, it's about time that we just absolutely destroy this movement that has destroyed so many lives. And I can't wait to see it wither away and slowly die and implode. You know, it's already starting. The trans community has been such a bad PR stunt for the rest of the LGBT, gender confusion movement, that they're trying to divorce from them. They have all these protests against guys in women's sports, but they have no protests against girls in men's spaces. Why is that? You know, I mean, it's always the men that get shafted. It's always the men that get screwed over, you know, and it's really kind of disappointing seeing how eager people are to bash the guys infiltrating girls' spaces, but then, like, when women do the same, it's like, oh man, like, yeah, women infiltrating guys' spaces, yeah. There's no protesting against that. We just watch them get bodied, and they probably like it too. Like, yeah, there's no backlash against that. Yeah. but it's our little girls. Oh, man. Yeah. I feel like both sides should be taken equally because there is infiltration in men's spaces by women. But, yeah, there's been a lot of banning of transgenderism from athletics as well. Banning of transgenderism from athletics. People, the one guy, the one senator they just caught doing, or senator's aide or something like that, doing filming gay porn in a Senate building. What is wrong with you people? Ew, it's just disgusting. What is on another man that you don't already have? Like, you know, it's just absolutely degenerate and disgusting, you know, and it's, people are tired of it. You know, people are so sick of it, you know, and I'm glad that all of this culminated in that protest, culminated in the consistent protests of the LGBTQIA, whatever ideology in schools, in every facet of our lives. Companies that are pushing it, in film and media are getting roasted, are getting absolutely destroyed. Companies like Disney, companies like Netflix and Target have lost billions. I mean, they've lost money, man, like real money, pushing this nonsense. And they don't seem to care because they're getting kickbacks from BlackRock. BlackRock has been slowly Larry Fink has been kind of distancing himself from the DEI kind of label that they have, diversity, equity, and inclusion, which is basically the ideology that's pushing all of this. I mean, we've had LGBT characters in media for years now. We have degenerate gay show, like just outright abominations on TV right now, just pushing this nonsense to kids. And parents nowadays, they don't really care enough to watch what their kids are watching, you know, or before their kids turn out like this. And then I remember back in the day, they tried to say, oh, we're born this way, we're this and that, we're born this way. And, you know, it's just like, yeah, we're born trans, and this, they try to brainwash these people so bad, you know. And the fact that you can't see the brainwashing, like, really, bro? You can't see that this guy is trying to catch you in a cult? These are cult tactics, you know, telling you that you're born gay, that you can never break out of this, being gay, and that you're hopeless, you know, and that there's no out to being gay, that, you know, that you're, whatever psychological problems you have, like whether it's, you know, hating men or whatever, and hating your father, or hating your mother or whatever, deep down, or resenting them in some way, you know, caused you to be this, or whether you suffered some kind of sexual abuse that caused you to be this, you know, there's no escape for you, bro. You're just gay, and that's it. You know, you're born this way, and that's not true. And thankfully, I can attest to one person that I know of this year who seems to have come out of the gay lifestyle that I've been praying for so long. This girl I know, won't name her, but I'm very close friends with her grandmother. She and her parents went through a nasty divorce. They're from back home in Rhode Island. But her little brother, who I'm so proud of and I'm so happy for, his name's Nate, but I probably shouldn't have said that. But anyway, he's an Orthodox priest now. And we were all raised as Methodists. We all came up as Methodists. But this girl, I guess she wasn't as confident about herself because of her weight. And she was a pretty girl, too. I mean, I'm like, yo, you're going to have all the guys after you, you know? Like, you know, and you know, I was a little older than her, but like, you know, I always liked her. She was always a likable person. You know, I was disappointed with her lifestyle choice, being that she was raised in a Christian home. But, you know, it's just, I'm so glad to see her come out of that. because not everyone has come out of that, you know. And I see some of my friends that I've known from high school, that I went to high school with, getting into the cult at the age of like 20 something, after they leave high school and go to college and all that nonsense. They get into the cult. They get indoctrinated. And it's really sad to see. I mean, it's a satanic ideology that teaches you to hate yourself, teaches you to hate men, teaches you to hate women. And you may not realize that it's doing that, but that's exactly what it's doing. You know, I mean, it's teaching you that, oh yeah, you don't need men, or like, you don't need women, or blah, blah, blah. Like, you can, you know, use men the same way you use women, but you don't need women. It's just it's so twisted. It really is so twisted, you know. And seeing Uganda and Japan banning these ideologies, or, well, at least combating them a little bit, is a sight for sore eyes. And I'm glad that that happened this year. You know, there's going to be a lot more protests and a lot more pushback against this ideology. You know, and so I heard that she has a boyfriend now. You know, to get back on the topic of the story, but like, I heard that she has a boyfriend now, and I'm so happy for her. You know, but there are other people who I'm still praying for. You know, like this one girl. I mean, she was fine back in high school. I mean, like, she was fine, like model quality, bro. And I used to like turn into a blubbering idiot whenever I saw her. I didn't know what to say. I was just like, and she was younger than me, you know. And, you know, but we were both in high school, and it was just like, yo, like, she's smoking hot, bro. And I used to, like, I mean, like, she had, like, some bazookas on her. I'm like, dang, bro, like, what was that, like, D cup? Like, she's, like, only in, like, 10th grade. I'm like, bro. But, like, yo, I didn't know what to say to her, so I was just like, hey, what, blah, blah, blah. But, like, she... I don't know if she thought I was, like, making fun of her or something like that. Sometimes the way you talk to people can damage their confidence, and that's always lingered in the back of my mind. Like, dang, did I destroy her confidence and her femininity or something like that? Did I do that? Like, because I check up on her now 10 years after high school or so, like almost 15 years after high school, after I left high school. And she, I mean, she very confident in her feminine form. She could have easily been a model, easily been a freaking supermodel with the look she had, you know. And now she's, I guess she had like French ancestry or something like that, but she was fine, bro. Gorgeous hair, head of hair, and some big, you know what, but like she was gorgeous. Yeah, I saw her profile recently is freaking Ricky. I mean, but like, I was just like, bro, like, you could have easily been having the easy life, living it up in a freaking mansion, doing whatever the fuck you wanted to do. I mean, like, you're, I mean, like, she's, you know, freaking fine though, but like, it's just like, why would you mutilate yourself like that? Why would you do that to yourself? Like, do you hate yourself? Is there something wrong with you? Like, you know, like, that you're not telling people about? Like, you need to talk? You know, and so I know that a lot of these LGBT people, they say, like, oh, yeah, it all started because I was sexually abused or because I was touched the wrong way. So I don't know if that's her case. I pray to God for her. I hope she comes out of it. You know, but it's just sad to see people destroying themselves, beautiful young people destroying themselves because of this ideology that teaches them that they're not sufficient how they are. And you are. You're God's creation. You know, you're God's creation. How much more sufficient do you want to be? You know, like, what more do you want to add to yourself? Like, do you want to add yellow hair, blue hair, green hair? Do you want to create up a new identity for yourself? You're sufficient the way you are. You're fine just the way you are. And it's sad to see so many people get sucked into this ideology. You know, and I mean, she's not transitioned yet, but like, she's still, you know, it looks like she's headed down that path. And I feel bad for her, you know, because she looks like she's going to be another victim of this ideology, another victim of this transgender ideology that teaches you to hate who you are and to change who you are. Because, you know, I'll tell you, oh, you're not doing this because you hate yourself. You're doing this because you love yourself. You know, it's such a twisted brain fuck, this ideology. And to see it, pushed to the next generation is just sickening. You know, seeing these little kids, these confused little kids grow up. I mean, having seen a grown man gyrating naked at a pride parade, seeing that grow up into a man and thinking, oh, well, this is just normal. This is just how normal people act. No, it is not. And then having the after being warned for the past 20 years about this is where it's going to lead to pedophilia, having been warned, now all of a sudden seeing them, oh, flabbergasted that this could ever happen. Oh, man, how could this ever happen? Well, when your entire identity revolves around sexual degeneracy and amoral sexual acts and a removal of God from the equation, what can we tell you? I mean, like, it's just like, what else is there? We told you this was going to happen, and now it's happening. And now we don't really have to protest, but like, it's just to show that we're not going to tolerate this nonsense. And I'm glad that the pushback is there. The energy is there. 2024 just needs to be the year of more. Just need to have more of that, more pushback against this hateful ideology that pushes self-hatred and self-loathing, that pushes degenerate nonsense to kids and teens and people in college, fills their head with all this absolute crap, okay, that everything is the same, everything is equal, oh, the both genders are equal, wrong, you could be any gender you want, wrong, a man and a man is a marriage, wrong, and all these churches that have been thoroughly infiltrated by these people. You know, we have to stand against them. We have to make our presence known. We have to take over these spaces. We have to use the momentum that we have going forward, because the gay community has lost the moral high ground. They have lost any kind of excuse to be morally indignant with us. They are literal pedophile enablers. You know, and it's sad. It's really sad to see just how far we've fallen in the past 15 years. You know, and it was never like this. It was not like this before. For all my younger viewers, there was a time where none of this stuff was like really out there like that. You know, these people were fringe degenerates, and they still are. They still are fringe degenerates. It's just that they're louder now. They're given a bigger microphone by all these companies that want to push this division and nonsense within our country. And to divide in our identity and conquer us, you know. They want to divide us by race, by ethnicity, by sexual degeneracy, by whatever they can do to destroy this nation, to destroy the fabric of our society. They will infiltrate any spaces they want. These people are ruthless, and they are evil. And so if you're taking any pointers from feminists or any of these modern day cults, that's what I like to call them, modern day cults, feminists, atheists, the LGBT, whatever, the alphabet mob or whatever they call them, you know, whatever they want to be known as, any of these godless, Christ-hating ideologies, you know, if you want to take your advice from them, I mean, it's only going to lead to your destruction. And I've seen so many stories online, people talking about how the LGBT community destroyed their lives, how the ideology destroyed their lives. So many ex-gays that the media refuses to talk about, ex-trans people that the media refuses to talk about, people that have come out of the lifestyle and are waking other people up to the reality that this ideology is of Satan, it is not of God, and that it seeks to destroy people. They push it in media. That's why they have to push it in media. They're trying to brainwash you. Mass media, they're trying. The gay Superman, the gay, all these gay characters are being pushed for a reason. there is an agenda. And when we said this 15 years ago, the gay agenda is ultimately pedophilia. Oh, you're a Christian bigot. You're this and that. You're a massive bigot, bro. Yeah, we're seeing all that. We're seeing the results of acceptance now. And tolerance is not a Christian value. You know, this movement teaches you to hate yourself, and but it disguises it as love, you know. And that's the most twisted part of it. We have, I mean, I began to see the seeds of the LGBT agenda when I was a kid being pushed in media, like with Jadzia Dax, who's a character from Star Trek, who in her past life was a man, but she's really a symbiote, but her symbiote was transferred to, and the memories of that, of the old life, were transferred to another host, which was a woman. And so one of her lovers from the past life came and was like, oh, you're still the same person. And they were like, oh yeah, this is kind of taboo. And they kissed at the end. They did a lesbian kiss at the end. And that was kind of, I kind of remember that from when I was a kid, you know, and I recently saw that episode again, but it was kind of the start for me where I kind of noticed the lesbianism being pushed, and they know that they have to get guys in on it somehow. They weren't going to do it with the gay movement at the forefront. So they had to push, ooh, two hot women kissing. Oh yeah, this is what lesbianism is like. And that's not how it's like. It's more like two miserable, ugly women kissing for the most part, or fighting for the most part. But they do have some cute lesbians out there that I'm like, dang, you couldn't find a guy? Like, I mean, you look good as hell. Like, you know, you couldn't find a guy? You look really nice. I mean, some of them do. Like, I see it all the time. Like, I even knew a girl who was a lesbian, and her partner basically kind of left that, and praise God for that. She left that lifestyle, but I was really hoping for her to leave the lifestyle because she is a beautiful woman, you know? And, you know, all this lifestyle leaves you, the gay lesbian lifestyle leaves you, is misery. Misery and STDs. That's all it leaves you, misery and STDs, you know, and lots of health problems, trying to pretend that another man's, I can't even think about it, the another man's anus is, it's just, oh God, ew, just, oh, it disgusts me to no end, just, ugh. Dude, but, anyway, that's the state of the world today, and hopefully it gets better in 2024. I'm hoping for more protests against this corrupting ideology, and I know I've ranted at length almost an hour now about it, but it's like, it has to stop somewhere, and you are what you tolerate, and if you don't tolerate it, these people will finally take you seriously. And I think LA, they finally started to take us seriously. They finally realized, oh man, maybe the gay movement isn't as popular as we keep saying it is. Yeah, and they were kind of quiet ever since then. But a lot of people have been really pissed off by the gay agenda and everything. And I'm really happy about it. I'm really happy that it's starting to implode and crumble in on itself. I hope it continues to dissolve into nothingness, and that people don't honestly start looking at the principled gay as something that they should look to as a shining example of what a gay person is, because that is not the case. That is not the case. The whole point of the whole LGBT movement was pedophilia, and they attached the T to the acronym almost 20 years ago now. So they should know who these people are. That they're mostly sex offenders, you know, and they're trying to be around children. They're trying to break children the same way they were probably broken as a child. So, I mean, Doctor Who now is a black gay guy. They've been trying to ride the coattails of those black civil rights movements for decades, and I guess having a black and gay person fills out two boxes. Two diversity boxes. Mystique being a blue bisexual, apparently to shit on Christians even harder in media. They recently had, this is just what's going on in mass media right now, just how they push this agenda. They've had, to shit on Christians a little bit, they've had Nightcrawler, my favorite X-Man from childhood, right next to Gambit and Wolverine. They've had Nightcrawler, the deeply devout Christian and Catholic priest, who looks like a demon, have his mother in Destiny. Two pure women, apparently just create him. They retconned his whole backstory, so apparently he's no longer the son of Azazel. Azazel is just some guy out there, and so they somehow just magically created him, which is just absolute dog shit. And then you wonder why comic sales are declining, and it's declining because people have had enough. And they hate God, they hate your family, and they display it every chance they get, and until you stop buying this shit, it's just going to continue. I mean, so that's why you have to protest with your money, with your pocketbooks, with your wallets. Boycott all of this nonsense, and it will stop. It will cease. Disney might try to resist a little bit, but, they'll go down eventually too. But mass media shows, even good shows like Gotham, where the plot is very nice. The plot is a very intense plot, Machiavellian kind of plots, and really kind of an interconnected story. DC has some very good story writers, but then, of course, they had to add the LGBTQIA+ representation up in there with Barbara Gordon. Basically giving Jim Gordon, the worst humiliation that a man could ever have is having his woman cheat on him with another woman. That's either a very bad humiliation or a really cool turn on. Depends on what you're into. But having that happen to him, after she said, "Oh yeah, I'll share half of your load. This is what marriage is all about." She came back to Gotham to be with him, and then she's over there cheating with him? I don't understand. It did make a look of sense, but they had to add that in there, and that's... I'm watching the series now. I'm trying to complete it, but it's just like seeing the parts with Montoya is just ugh. Just, ugh, man. No. Nope. Doesn't do it for me. So... anyway, 2023 has been the end of LGBT, at least in terms of popularity, and a severe decline in likability amongst the populace. So here's to 2024 and a whole lot more, and a whole lot more of my videos, hopefully about something other than a satanic cult, a satanic cult of self-hatred. I hope that this year, 2024, brings about a restoration of what love is, because people have conflated sex with love, and that's not the same. Sex is just an act, but what I'm talking about is like a real love on a spiritual level, where you appreciate a person for who they are, and they complete you. And I hope 2024 restores that, restores the sense of normalcy that we used to have not so long ago. I look at it now, and I'm like, dang, it's been, almost 10, 15 years since high school, and I can't believe it's been that long. And it seems like so long ago where the world was somewhat normal. But now everything it seems like everything is falling apart, but it's up to us to put it back together. Christians need to organize against pride, against any of this. garbage against pastors who are trying to stop you from organizing, you should put them out, kick them out, and take charge. Honestly, tell anyone who's willing to stand against this madness to follow you, you know, and just see where it leads. I mean, I already see the seeds are there, and we just need time and a lot of effort and a lot of brave souls to put forth the word of God to these people. Let them know the truth, that this is not right. You know? And yeah, they'll mock you, they'll deride you, but just remain steadfast. And that's the hardest thing, remaining steadfast in your beliefs in the face of mockery and derision. But it's happened before. It's happened to us for the past 2,024 years. They've been mocking us ever since, and they've been losing, and we just stay here. We'll see the next generation of these degenerates probably further down the line. It won't stop. I mean, it won't stop until the end times and Christ comes back. The Messiah is with us, and so we have nothing really to fear. All right, guys. Just my two cents on Pride Month. Mad props to the man that organized the Dodgers protest and all those people who said we have had enough of the mockery of our religion. Meanwhile, we can't mock y'all. The hypocritical attitude of the degenerate Pride movement. And the people who just had enough of seeing the slippery slope argument go from, oh, it's a fallacy, oh, you guys are crazy, it'll never come to that, to actually seeing it in real life 15, 20 years later. And as someone who lived back then, who lived and heard all these arguments against gay marriage, heard the warnings of people 20, 15 years ago talking about, like, oh, dude, like 2007, 2008, even earlier than that, 2004, talking, saying if you legalize gay marriage, it will lead to a whole bunch of degeneracy. It will lead to a man in a freaking shoebox, a man in a dog being able to get married, a man in a, what is the standard anymore? Like, it'll cause chaos sexually if you promote this nonsense, to being proven right from, you know, over the past 15 years, as we see little kids being taken to pride parades where grown men are half naked gyrating with their junk all over the place. To see that happen in real time, you know, to see the pictures and to hear these sick fucks talking like, oh yeah, we'll convert your children, guys, and there's nothing you can do about it. To hear them actually say that, yeah, I know I'm right. I know I'm right. All right. Anyway, this is your boy Coast. Get out there and make the world a better place, guys. And free it from these satanic cultists, these DEI companies that are trying to change the way we think. They're trying to social engineer all of this. They're trying to hack our brains, hack the brains of our kids, to groom them and into becoming degenerates and moral degenerates. Take back your society. Take back your country. Take back your world. This is your boy Coast, the Jedi Battlemaster, bringing you the battle tactics. This is how we fight back. And I love you guys. Thank you for supporting me. Thank you for showing me that there's still hope out there. And don't forget to fight the Antichrist everywhere you go. Fight the influence of Satan everywhere you go. In your holiest name, God, I thank you for all you've done for us. All right. Peace. Thank you.
If you're gay, then you're gay. Don't pretend that you're straight. You could be who you are any day of the week. You are unlike the others. So strong and unique. So strong and unique. So strong and unique. So strong.